Panel, faculty members, and my dear student managers. Today, I, Chaitrali Nare, along with my partner, Aditi Budhale, are here from River Godavari, and we are going to present our topic, which my partner will introduce to you.
First of all, very good morning to everyone here. I hope that you are charged after this exercise that we just did. Okay, so before we begin with our presentation, I would like you all to, you know, guess what is our topic of the day. Okay, for that we are going to show you clues, three clues, and you have to, you know, find a link between them. If you find the link, you are reaching to our topic. Okay, you'll guess our topic. And I have also a few chocolates with me, so I'm going to distribute the first person who answers it. Okay, can I have this slide? Next slide, please. So we have Deepika Padukone.
I must say, we have a smart group of audience today.
I'm sorry for that. Okay, so moving forward, next slide please. So you guessed it right that it is TANISHQ. Next slide please.
Yeah, so the contents which we are going to walk you through for today's presentation are the brand philosophy, and it will derive our objective for today's presentation, the introduction, TANISHQ collections, the marketing strategy, the quarter 3 financial year 2019-21 financial data, the factors contributing to TANISHQ success, the SWOT analysis, and finally to sum up the conclusion.
Next slide please.
Yeah, so basically the brand philosophy. So at TANISHQ, the quality is given the highest value. And also TANISHQ is famous due to its superior craftsmanship, the exclusive designs, and the highest level of quality checks that are carried from time to time. Also, as we all know, TANISHQ is considered as one of the India's top jewelry brand because it is coupled with a perfect blend of traditional values as well as the modern values, meaning it has a wide range of wedding collection, exclusive wedding collections to the contemporary jewelry, which we can consider for our daily office wear purposes. And also it has legitimate sales and employment practices. That is, for all the purchases and the transactions which are going in and out of TANISHQ, they follow all the legitimate practices. So basically, due to all these reasons, I feel TANISHQ is definitely one of the top brand, and I would like to share the success of it with my fellow audience today. Also to add on, I personally am a loyal and a faithful customer of TANISHQ, and I'm sure many of you amongst the audience must also be. Am I right? Yes. So to proceed forward.
I'm going to present a quick introduction and the history of TANISHQ. So TANISHQ was the first ever jewelry retail company which was started by Titan, and it is backed by the Tata Group. The first store was opened in 1996 in Bengaluru, and the TANISHQ, like previously I used to think that TANISHQ was, you know, TAN, that is the body, and ISHQ, that is you love your body. I felt that was the meaning of the name, but then later on, after this research, I found out that NISHQ is the division of the word, and that means the gold ornament. There's an interesting story of TANISHQ that to begin with, they had begun manufacture of watches, the gold watches which are embedded with stones. But then later they gradually shifted to the jewelry, catering to the needs of women. And TANISHQ now has 274 plus stores in 160 plus cities. Next slide. So this is the myriad of collections that TANISHQ has. It ranges from the corporate wear, the jewelry which we wear day to day in our day to day lives, and also for the heavy jewelry for the bridal wear. And gentlemen in the house, you need not be feel left out, because they also have the collection for men, which is the Aveer collection. And these all are the various collections. Next slide.
Yeah, so coming over to the marketing strategy of TANISHQ, it definitely follows a superior marketing strategy, and which we will be categorizing with the help of 4 P's, that is the product, the price, the place and the promotions. So coming over to the first one, product. Basically, TANISHQ is considered as a recognized brand with qualitative products and innovative designs. Also, as my partner just mentioned, it deals with a varied variety of collections ranging from the daily wear to the exclusive high-end jewelry, and also it deals with gold, diamond, platinum and all the high-end products. Also, coming to the price, basically TANISHQ follows a high premium pricing policy. So, and also the price is varied at a larger scale, and also there are with respect to price, there is an online website of TANISHQ wherein we can find the product information and we can go through the designs, and also the purchase becomes easier. Then the place, it has its presence in over 160 plus cities, and there are 274 plus stores, and also the stores are like the showrooms are designed in such a way that they mainly occupy the high like the high end places in the cities, so which definitely serves as a plus point. Also, it has expanded its stores, like the pallet stores in overseas, that is in USA, to name Chicago and New Jersey. Coming to promotion, it again adopts an extensive marketing policy wherein, as we had started with the introduction, the famous actress Deepika Padukone is the brand ambassador, and definitely she helps to create a positive strategy amongst the common customer base. And also the promotion is strong through social media, the newspaper, Facebook and likewise. Next slide, please.
Okay, so these are the financial figures which we got, but that is for the Titan company, which is under which TANISHQ comes in. So the revenue for the quarter of 2018-19 was 5,934.11 for Titan, and out of this 84% was contributed by TANISHQ. Next slide, please. So these are the factors which contribute to the success of TANISHQ. So first is the product philosophy. They stick to very high standards, and they are very committed to their quality. And they also have this this carat meter thing with them, which is very unique to them, and which is very unique to them. And in that, they measure the purity of gold without any destructive, that is the non-destructive method to measure the carat of the gold. So, and that is very unique to them. Then we have the design philosophy. As we've seen, they have very large collection for all the types of population. And the Karigar story, they have very well equipped machinery, and to work on them, they have very efficient artisans for that, and both and they are also happy in their place. Next slide, please.
Yeah, coming to over to the SWOT analysis, as it is a successful jewelry brand, definitely the strengths are more, as you can see. Just let me drive you through the strengths, main, opportunities, main weakness and threats. So firstly, it has a strong backing of Tata, Titan and the Tidco. So because of it, it has a large brand value. Then the trusted jewelry brand, it has the most brand recall, is very high for TANISHQ brand. Then right product mix due to its various varied designs. The promotional activities are excellent. The geographical presence is in India as well as overseas. It has got multiple awards for its design, innovations and the legacy which they are following, and endorsement by famous celebrities, that is through means of brand ambassadors. Then the weakness are, it is quite limited in the global market as compared to its competitors like the D-Damas, limited